If you want to continue to follow our adventure, click subscribe. So you don't miss anything, click the bell notification.
So today I thought I would bring you up to the top of this mountain, which is my backyard for, has been for the last, 8 days, and will be my backyard for a few more days. Thought I'd explain to you why you will never be a nomad. Now, this video does not apply to folks who are being forced into this lifestyle for, you know, circumstances, or those that have medical conditions. Obviously, I'm a big advocate that if you have a medical condition, that you need to thoroughly analyze your medical condition to ensure that you're safe if you decide to come live this lifestyle. Now, I'm sure that a lot of you are gonna think that the title of this video is very harsh, and how dare you tell me I'll never live this lifestyle? Of course I'm gonna live this lifestyle. And I'm gonna tell you how I'm gonna do it. So before you stop the video, I want to address with you some key fundamental things that is holding you back from living this lifestyle. And at the end of the video, I'm going to explain to you how you can overcome some of these things and define things. You know, I hear all the time that I want to do this lifestyle, but I gotta, my wife won't do it, or my grandchildren are here, or I love my home and I don't want to leave my home. You got any suggestions? Well, of course I have a suggestion. I have a suggestion that maybe, in all honesty, that the nomadic lifestyle is not your dream. If my wife did not want to do this, I wouldn't do it. That means I care for my wife a lot more than I care about this nomadic lifestyle or my children. Of course, I waited until my child was grown, because when I was raising my child, she was my number one priority. She was my goal. She was my dream. If I owned a home that I loved so much that I just couldn't leave it, well, then that's the dream. And you have decided that's what you want to do. Just because you want to come out here and live this lifestyle, this isn't the dream. This is like, it would be nice. I see so many people getting depressed because they can't come out here and live the lifestyle. Well, I'll tell you what's causing the depression is folks that are telling you, oh, this is the greatest lifestyle in the world. You're going to love it. Come on out here. It's perfect. And so you're conflicted. And then you know, they've implanted this beautiful scenery in the background into your head and said, the only way you're ever going to be able to see the scenery is if you live the nomadic lifestyle and this becomes your backyard for 2 weeks. Well, what about your backyard that you already have? Do you love that backyard? Can you just come and visit this one every now and then? Money seems to be a big one. Oh, I don't have the money to do whatever. Now, first of all, when it comes to money, I'm not going to talk about any other subject but two. One, you got to be debt free. If you're going to be free, if you're going to come out here and live the free lifestyle, you got to be debt free. And if you want to sleep well at night because you're worried that the mice might eat a wire in your engine compartment and you don't have any money to get it repaired, you're going to need an emergency fund, and a large emergency fund. We've talked about that. I'm not going to get into it today. So how do I get an emergency fund? How do I become debt free? Well, this is probably the easiest answer I can give, because I did it. I have a very large emergency fund and I am debt free, and I did it in 2 years. It was real simple. Stop spending money. If you don't need it to sustain life or to earn more money, then you don't need to spend the money. You know, Carolyn and I, we don't spend money. We can live 2, 3, 4 weeks without spending a dime. And we just did it. We had to spend $83. We went to the gas station. It was a very expensive gas station. But we had to buy gas for the truck, and we had to buy drinking water. Drinking water. Okay, that's an essential part of life. So we spent money on something that we had to have. Now, the only thing that we spend money on that we don't have to have is coffee. We buy a pound of coffee, or, you know, whatever those big tubs are, every few weeks, and we drink 2 pots of coffee a day. Beyond that, we don't spend any money. We don't drink alcohol. We don't drink soda. We don't spend money, period. The other one is I got to have the best equipment. And if you go to the other YouTube channels, they're telling you, you got to have this stuff, Rom. You got to have a huge van build, and you got to buy solar panels. Rob, here's the other one I hear all the time. Your camper is junk. You need to go buy a Class C, or you need to go buy a van, or you need to go buy a travel trailer. my response to this, and I'm not being rude, it's the point of the video, is I am living the dream. I am living my dream. I don't need big fancy equipment to live the dream. The dream was this, to make this my backyard for 2 weeks at a time. Not to have a big fancy camper. But the reality is, I'm living the dream in a homemade truck camper that cost $650 after it was all said and done. What more do I need? Just got chewed out the other day by somebody, sent me an email, very lengthy email, very upset with me. Rob, I've been trying to explain to you what you need to have. And he sends me this video that he made of his trailer. He's building a cargo trailer. And he's been working on this cargo trailer for years. And he says, once I have this finished, I'm going to go and do what you're doing. It's going to be so easy. So I replied back, so when will you be actually doing the lifestyle? And he never replied back. And the reason is because his dream isn't to come out here and live this lifestyle. His dream is to build a big fancy cargo trailer camper. Ah, here's a big one. Need more stuff, Rob. You need more stuff. I mean, I don't go by a day in the comment section or on Facebook or wherever. Somebody telling me you got to get something. Got to buy more tools. Got to buy solar panels. Got to buy a better refrigerator. You got to buy a bigger truck. You got to buy a Class C. You got to buy a fifth wheel. You got to buy a track. No, I don't have to buy anything. I've got the bare minimum that I need, and I'm living this lifestyle. So if you can't minimize your lifestyle down to, okay, this is what I need to live the dream, then maybe that's not the dream. Maybe the stuff is the dream. So now what are you going to do so you can live the dream? Well, here's what you got to do. There's two things. One, you got to define the dream. What is it? Is it really living the nomadic lifestyle? Or is it the stuff? Or is it the grandkids? Or is it the house? Or is it the garden? You got to define it. And you really need to sit down and say, okay, what is holding me back from doing the lifestyle? And if you can say, well, you know, the garden is, I really like the garden, then you need to write down, the dream is the garden. I can come visit this sometime. And then if you finally decide, okay, this is the dream. The nomadic lifestyle is the dream, but I'm afraid to do it. You know, I just don't know all the attributes of it. You got to do test runs. Well, Rob, I don't have a camper to do test runs in. Fine. If you really want to figure out if the nomadic lifestyle is for you, go get a tent. Try it out in your car. Really figure out if this is what you want to do. And if you decide, yeah, I really enjoyed my 3 months living in my car, now you can start focusing on the little things that's going to make this a little bit easier. Thanks for watching. Click like if you like the video, and happy travels.